So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty.
Hey, this is Pastor Adam Fannin at Law of Liberty Baptist Church here in Jacksonville, Florida. I want to give a word of encouragement to the Christians out there that now is the time to look for the future. Now is the time that we need to make goals and strive to obtain them. We should not be afraid of what the future holds for us. And I know you may say, well, we're about to be in the middle of a recession or a depression. Listen, God is bigger than that. And you say, well, what if we go to war, and what if everything changes in America? God is bigger than that, and we should not be afraid. We cannot afford to be afraid. We must set goals. We must look for the future right now. This is very important as Christians. God has called us to be leaders. The whole world is watching us, and they look at us because they hold us to a higher standard. They expect us to be like Christ, to be like the Lord Jesus Christ, and we need to do that. We need to make sure that we don't have the spirit of fear, but rather the spirit of love, the spirit of a sound mind. And in difficult times, when we don't know what the future holds, we need to trust the Lord, and we need to just lead with confidence. Here personally in our church, we're making goals for the next 10 years right now. We are setting goals that if the Lord would give us 10 years, what should we do with these 10 years? Instead of worrying about, will we be free tomorrow? Or will our country go back to normal in a month? I'm looking for the next 10 years, and I want to take the opportunities that the Lord sets before us, and I want to set goals and be a good steward of the time that we have. I want to have a larger church and a larger family. I want to see discipleship thrive in Jacksonville, Florida. I want to see brand new Christians become soul winners, get on fire for God, have a zeal for reading the Bible and leading their family in the right direction. And listen, we as Christians, again, we're called to be leaders in society. And you think about all the Christians throughout history that were fearless no matter what was in front of them. David's a great example, right? David was not afraid of the lion. He wasn't afraid of the bear. The Lord gave him strength to overcome those things. You think about Jehu, right? Another man. I mean, he went against Jezebel and Ahab, and the Lord gave him victory. That in itself was an awesome story. Many of the characters in the Bible, God brags on them because they had faith in Him. And that's what we ought to do as Christians, especially in this uncertain time. You think about the Apostle Paul. I mean, he went to Caesar. He fought against the synagogue of Satan. Peter was much the same way, always with zeal, never afraid to go to battle, but especially the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. He died on the cross for our sins. He overcame and got victory for us in probably the most difficult time of His life on earth. We need to follow in the footsteps of the great Christians that have gone on before us. We need to follow in the footsteps of the Lord Jesus Christ. We need to make sure that we are leading by example. That's what we're called to be as Christians. We're to be an example. We have an eternal testimony. What you do with your time here, as you set goals for preaching the gospel and raising godly children, this is something that can impact eternity. As Christians, we cannot afford to be afraid. We have to look to the future. We have to trust that the Lord will provide. And no matter what happens in America or in the world, we need to trust the Lord that He will provide. Listen, if you're saved, then you know what I'm talking about. You're filled with the Holy Spirit. You need to get over your fears and you need to look to the future and get ready for the future. Use your time now wisely, and God will bless you both here and there. If you're not saved, if you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, I would encourage you to watch the video Directions to Heaven from Florida. I'll put a link. Directions to Heaven from Florida. It tells you everything you need to know to go to heaven when you die. You must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You have to understand it's not by your works, it's the gift of everlasting life that He gave to us. Listen, in times like this, Christians should be leading the way, looking toward the future, not paralyzed by fear. If you're saved, get ready for the future and stop being afraid. God bless you.